Okay, students, so now today we have to discuss our exercise, exercise 12.1. Exercise 12.1 of the chapter Introduction to Three Dimensional Geometry. So, before going to study this exercise, you have to refer your introduction video. So, now question number one. Here, question is, a point is on x-axis, three-dimensional geometry, in which a point lies on x-axis, then what are its y-coordinates and z-coordinates? We are given that our point lies on x-axis. This is coordinate axis or coordinate space is there. This is x-axis, this one is y, and this one is z-axis. So here, our point lies on x-axis. Suppose one point is there, point lies on x-axis. What about its y-coordinate and z-coordinate? So any point which lies on x-axis, whose distance along with the y-axis is 0, distance along with the z-axis is 0. So coordinates are x, 0, 0. So here we can say y-coordinate of any point which lies on x-axis is 0, as well as z-coordinate of the point which lies on x-axis is 0. Clear? Next, question number 2. Question number 2. A point is in the xz plane. What can you say about its y-coordinate? Xz plane. This plane. This is our xz plane. So here point lies on this xz plane. So distance of this point along with the y-axis is again 0. So any point lies on xz plane, we can say y-coordinate of that point will be 0. If any point lies on this xz plane, distance of that point along with the y-axis is 0. Distance along with the y-axis, that means in right direction or in left direction. Distance along with the x-axis, that is in front direction, or it can be in back direction, or you can say backward direction. Distance along with this z-axis, that can be in upward direction, or it can be in downward direction. So here, any point which lies on this xz plane, that the distance of that point along with the y-axis will be 0. Done? So here, any point which lies on xz plane, its y coordinate is 0. Done? Now, next, question number 3. So, in question number 3, we have to name the octants in which following points lies. We have to give the number of octant, in which octant our given number lies. So, different numbers, different points are given. So, here, first point is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, what you have to think? We have to consider this x coordinate, y coordinate and z coordinate. Done? So here this x coordinate is positive. So it can be in front direction. So in first front direction, we are in total 8 octants. Done? So in front direction, now our y is also positive. So in front direction, our required octants are in rightward direction. So only 2 octants are there and z is also positive. So direction of z is upward direction. So you have to consider front, rightward and upward octant. That is nothing but the first octant. Clear? So point whose coordinates are 1, 2 and 3 will be lies in first octant. Is that clear? Second point. Coordinates of second points are, second point is 4, minus 2, 3. 4, minus 2, 3. Now, what about this? X coordinate, y coordinate, and z coordinate. First, we have to check this x coordinate. X coordinate is positive. So, we have to consider in front direction. So, in front direction, we are having total 8 octants. First, fourth, fifth, and eighth. Total 4 octants are there in front direction. Done? So, front, then y coordinate is negative. So y coordinate negative, we have to go in left direction. So in left direction, we are having only two octants. Done. And out of the two octants, we have to consider z direction. Z is positive. We have to consider upward direction. So front, left, and upward. The octant is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this point will lies in fourth octant. Done. So octant of this point will be fourth octant. Next one. Third point. That point is 4 minus 2 minus 5. So again, here x coordinate positive, front side, y coordinate is negative. Then you have to consider left side, and then z coordinate is negative, downward direction. So first, then left and downward. The number will be 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 quadrant will be there. Sorry, 8 octant will be there. So octant is 8th one. Next point, that is 4, 2, minus 5. Again, x coordinate is positive, so we have to consider front direction. No, front, then y is positive, then you have to consider rightward direction. Front direction, then rightward direction. And z is negative, downward direction. Done. So front mein right hand side par niche wala octant wo consider karna hai. So front mein right direction mein niche wala jo octant hai wo kaun sa aayega, hai na, one ke exactly niche. So 1, 2, 3, 4, uske baad niche 5, 6, 7, 8, to kaun sa number aa raha hai, 5. So that number is 5. So our point 4, 2, minus 5 will lies in fifth quadrant. Done. Then the point is -4, -4, 2, -5. -4, 2, -5. So here x coordinate is negative. X coordinate is negative. We have to go in backward direction. So हमारा जो total है ना, two floor का building है हमारा, है ना, जिसके अंदर total eight rooms है. अभी हमें consider करना है नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन, तो पीछे चले जाना है. पीछे के जो चार रूम होंगे ना, वो नीचे के दो, ऊपर के दो. सो नाउ अवर एक्स इज नेगेटिव, सो यू हैव टू गो इन बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. है ना, एक्स इज नेगेटिव, सो बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. वाई इज पॉजिटिव, तो बैक साइड पर आपको राइट साइड में जाना है. और उसका पर उसके बाद जेड, जेड इज नेगेटिव, डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन में. तो कौन सा ऑक्टेंट आ रहा है ना, एक्स नेगेटिव पीछे, वाई पॉजिटिव राइट डायरेक्शन पर, जेड नेगेटिव नीचे. तो पीछे की साइड नीचे वाला कॉर्नर है ना, कौन सा, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. तो नीचे वाला कॉर्नर वाला आ रहा है, दैट मींस 6 नंबर का ऑक्टेंट, दैट इज ऑक्टेंट नंबर 6. एक्स नेगेटिव पीछे, वाई पॉजिटिव राइट डायरेक्शन, जेड नेगेटिव नीचे वाला. तो 5 एंड उसके बाद 6, 6 नंबर. डन. 6 नंबर. -4, 2, -5. After that, -4, 2, -5. Then -4, 2, 5. -4, 2, 5. Now here, x coordinate is negative, backward direction. Y coordinate positive. So backward direction. उसके बाद rightward direction and z positive upward direction. तो ऊपर वाला floor. 1 and 2. So this one is octant number 2. Octant number 2. Done. Then number is -3, -1, 6. -3, -1, 6. X negative piche, y negative right direction par, z positive upari. 1, 2, and 3. Quadrant number 3. This will be in, sorry, octant, and a quadrant word nikal raha hai bari bari se, lekin octant number 3. Octant number 3. Then the last point, that is 2, -4, -7. 2, -4, -7. So here, 2 positive, फ्रंट डायरेक्शन में आएगा, फ्रंट आगे वाला। वाई नेगेटिव आगे, उसके बाद में लेफ्ट डायरेक्शन पर एंड नीचे, फ्रंट डायरेक्शन उसके बाद लेफ्ट डायरेक्शन उसके बाद डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, तो कौन सा आएगा? 1 2 3 4 ऊपर आ गया, उसके बाद नीचे 5 6 7 और 8 नंबर का आएगा। सो दिस विल बी इन ऑक्टेंट नंबर 8। सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैन फाइंड द ऑक्टेंट इन विच गिवन पॉइंट लाइज। डन। देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, हियर वी हैव टू फिल इन द ब्लैंक। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज x axis and y axis taken together determine the plane. x axis and y axis taken together determine the plane, that is xy plane. Our answer will be xy plane. First answer will be xy plane. Second one, the coordinates of the points in xy plane, any point which lies in xy plane whose z coordinate is 0, so coordinate will always be in the form of x, y and 0, because any point which lies in xy plane whose z coordinate will always 0. Clear, students? And then third, fill in the blank. Coordinates, a coordinate of plane divide this space into total 3 coordinate planes are there, and total 3 coordinate planes are there, 3 coordinate axes are there, x o x dash, y o y dash, z o z dash, or we can say 3 coordinate planes are there, x y plane, y z plane and x z plane. So this 3 coordinate plane will divide our space, this coordinate plane divide our space into 8 octants, divide our space into 8 octants. Clear, students? So this is the solution of your exercise number 12.1.